Tappei has just released Arc 7 Chapter 18, so this will be a summary of that chapter. If you haven't already, I highly recommend you check my summary for Chapter 17. Anyways, let's get started. The chapter starts with a scene that Subaru remembers. In a dense forest, he was determined to escape, using the Elgina witch beast to cause harm and provide him with the opportunity to run away. Subaru did this by weighing what was important to him and what wasn't, and therefore that was the result. People who did not know how to fight against a magical beast may have been killed or overpowered instantly. It's something that Subaru didn't want to think about. However, that was wrong. Subaru should acknowledge that his choice may have killed those who were on the other side of the scale. These people were not witches or archbishops. They were people who acted maliciously and were following orders from above. Regardless, Subaru would have to pay for Subaru's actions. The scene changes back to Flop asking Subaru to not frown. Immediately seeing Flop's face, Subaru wants to vomit as he remembers Flop's head being split open. Subaru kneels down, barely hearing Flop's words. Subaru utters one word, Todd. This was the person Subaru knew from the encampment, and was also the person who carried out the tragedies before. The burning tavern with black smoke. Drunks fell one by one to the axe due to the smoke, which seemed to be tear gas laced with pungent spices. A magic stone was placed to start a fire and to block the entrance, leading the survivors to the back door. The back door was locked, and then when the door was open, in that brief moment, the best man can then be attacked by surprise. He then also had a wet cloth to stave off the smoke. It was all Todd. He survived the events in the Budheim jungle. At least that was Subaru jumping to conclusions that Todd died. While so many people did die during the attack on the camp and during the fight with the witch beast, Subaru didn't ponder that people would have survived. And with this city being closest to the Valakian encampment, it's only natural that the survivors would arrive here. Subaru then realizes that this is an enemy, and it's the first time it's an enemy where it's not, say, a witch or a witch beast. Subaru bit the inside of his cheek and blood poured out. He wouldn't wallow in defeat. He needs to move forward. Flop offered Subaru water, and Subaru states he's okay and knows he needs to move, since of course Todd's attack will be in motion. Subaru states he needs to get his medicine from Rem for his chronic condition. Flop of course agrees, and Subaru ponders. If Flop and Subaru split up, it's only natural that Todd would prioritize Subaru. Subaru would then go to the tavern, get Rowan, and avoid the surprise attack. Flop then went back to the inn to get the medication, and Subaru began to enact his plan, hoping that Rowan was the strongest in Valakia. As Subaru ran, he heard a scream from an alleyway and peered in. Inside, he saw Flop, who was injured and stabbed in the leg. Subaru ran at him, not calculating that they would target Flop instead. Subaru planned on taking Flop somewhere safe, and it was lucky that he was hit in the leg, which wasn't vital. As Subaru grabbed Flop, he wondered why, and of course he realized that snipers tend to wound targets, and then when their friend comes to help, they can then strike both down. As Subaru thinks about this, he sees a shimmering, and he turns around and he gets hit in the head. As momentum carries him down the alleyway, Subaru tries to touch his forehead, only for his hand to get blown off, revealing bone. We also see that Subaru's left hand is also broken, with fingers pointing in different directions. This time the attacker did not hide his face, it was Todd, and Subaru made a mistake of trying to help Flop without any defense. Subaru glares at Todd, but Todd doesn't really show any emotion. Todd states that he needs to sharpen his axe better. As Todd went to kill Subaru, Subaru tried to speak. Todd just continued and raised the axe. However, at the last second, someone jumped on Todd. This person was Flop. Flop, who was bearing through the pain, shouted at Subaru to run away at the expense of his own life. Todd, of course, was stronger, pulled Flop off, and then killed him with an axe to the head. Subaru wondered who the hell Todd was. Subaru stated that he knew why Todd was targeting him. However, Subaru thought to himself, targeting people like Flop, who had nothing to do with him, wasn't okay. Todd actually explains it differently. Subaru is dangerous, so he has to die. There is no other emotions or reasons tied behind it. Todd states he won't give Subaru any time. Subaru asks for him to wait, and Todd says there is no waiting, as Subaru is killed again. Subaru responds to the usual chatter of not frowning from Flop. Subaru went pale. It's only been around 20 minutes, and Subaru has died 5 times. This was different to the Watchtower. He died 15 times there, but he was making progress with every death. This time he wasn't making anything. Todd is keeping an eye on Subaru, even at this moment, so the second that Subaru split up with Flop, Flop got attacked. If Subaru used Flop as bait, it would be fine, but Subaru will do everything he can to save Flop. It's not the same thing as, say, weighing Rem's life to Todd's, for example, but Flop is a great friend, and therefore Subaru won't let him die. Subaru can't go to the inn since Todd might find out where Rem is, and if Todd only spotted Subaru right now, then Rem would be safe if he doesn't go back to the inn. In fact, since Todd is very systematic, if he knew where Rem was, then he would have used Rem as a hostage to kill Subaru. If Subaru splits up, Todd would automatically attack, and if he waited for a counterattack, then he wouldn't win as he doesn't have a weapon or a way to win in one counterattack towards Todd's attack. The best bet would be to get Rowan. Subaru lambasts at the fact that Todd is his enemy. At least with the Sin Archbishops, if you unravel how their authorities work, you can beat them, but Todd is smart and systematic. He doesn't care what happens and just kills Subaru and those around him. Whatever he says to the other people after Subaru is killed doesn't really matter. Flop asks if Subaru wants to go back to the inn. Subaru states that that's a no-no. If Subaru did something weird, Todd would be suspicious, and therefore the info he got from Return by Death would be useless. In other words, Subaru must use the fact that he knows Todd will attack to his advantage. Then Subaru gets an idea. In the last loop, Todd stated that it's not because of his resentment that he kills vipers, but he kills vipers because he fears them. In other words, he's surprise attacking Subaru since he's trying to limit damage to himself because he fears Subaru. Knowing this, Subaru shouts out for Todd. Flop was of course surprised, and Subaru is sure that Todd is listening and also surprised. Subaru continues shouting, "You're a stubborn bastard. I thought you were dead after what happened to you, but I won't let you go this time. I'll kill you." Subaru continues to look around and shouting in anger, stating that he's looking forward to seeing Todd run around in fear. Subaru had an idea and headed towards where Todd would be hiding and stated that Todd can set him up and he would then tear Todd apart. This is what made Todd different from an archbishop. He would most likely be very calculated and look for another opportunity to attack. Subaru had many things to do, to stay in the city and get Rowan, or to try and escape with Rem and Flop and Medium. And that's what he decided to do, escape from the city. Subaru left the place and Todd didn't make any moves. He had to act fast before Todd realized that it was a bluff. Subaru and Flop raced back to the inn and went to Rem's room. Medium nearly decapitated Subaru but stopped after realizing it was him. Subaru hugged Rem and Rem told him to let go and Subaru apologized. Subaru explained that the bad guys have found him and they need to leave. Flop also states he will go with Subaru and convinces Medium to come as well. They go to the stables to get their actual carriage, which has an ox beast called a fallow. The name of this ox beast is called Botecliff, but it was very, very slow and Subaru was getting urgent. Medium took out her swords and started scraping them to create a large sound, which caused the Botecliff to start running towards the entrance of the city. The carriage was weaving through the streets, dodging left and right. However, it wouldn't be that easy. There was a line of Imperial soldiers blocking the way to the checkpoint. In other words, after the alley confrontation, Todd got more of his allies to help. Taking the lead of the men was a man with an eye patch, Jamal, who stated that he would kill Subaru. With that said, Medium jumped off the carriage and started smacking up the Imperial soldiers, creating a path for Subaru and the crew. However, Jamal got involved and attacked Medium, who blocked the attack. Subaru realized that Jamal is very strong. In fact, the reason why they survived is most likely due to Jamal's presence back when the Elgina attacked. Medium was getting cornered, and as long as Jamal was around, escaping would be hard. Rem handed Subaru a rope and held a crate and threw it at Jamal. Jamal cut it in half, but it had spices inside, which poured over him, catching him off guard. This then caused him to be sidetracked. Medium then grabbed the rope, which Subaru was holding, and Subaru pulled her back onto the carriage, and then she dropped her swords onto the carriage. They then dart out of the city. Jamal then comes up for a follow-up attack, but Rem then throws the backpack at his face. Soon after, an axe goes for Subaru's head, killing him before anyone else could react, or so it seemed, since Subaru was expecting it and blocked it with Medium's barbarian sword, which was on the carriage. Subaru and Todd were in a fight as Todd tries to drive the axe into Subaru's skull. Lewis jumped in and grabbed Todd, and Todd elbowed her in the face. Todd went in for another swing at Subaru, but Subaru, knowing that they were now outside of the city, called out for Kuna and Holly, only for an arrow to hit Todd in the side of the head, knocking him off the carriage. Rem was then cradling Lewis, and Subaru muttered to himself that he would definitely hit the bad-natured Emperor when he comes back. Subaru spits this out as he thinks of the face of the man who would have known everything. And the chapter ends. So yeah, for those of you that are unaware, I literally made a video like a week ago called Why Underestimating Vincent is Wrong. And this is exactly what I'm talking about. If you have not watched that video, do not downplay or lowball Vincent. This guy knows everything. He can calculate everything. He knew exactly what was going to happen and he put a strategy in advance. And of course, Subaru caught onto that strategy. And this is the one reason why, like, maybe that's the reason why Vincent didn't say goodbye to Subaru a few chapters ago, because he knew Subaru would be coming back. So that's what I'm talking about when it comes to Vincent versus Priscilla. Like, don't downplay Vincent. As for the actual chapter though, yeah, I feel it was really good. And we can see why Todd was assassinating Subaru, because he was essentially scared of Subaru. And yeah, that was interesting. Todd elbowed Lewis, so I'm not happy about that. As for if Todd is dead, I don't think so. I think he'll still be alive, but he'll also have an eye patch. I'm not sure, but let me know what you think, and thank you to my channel members.